So today we can discuss on the another concept of the digital altimeters, that is resolution and sensitivity. Resolution directly or indirectly it refers to the number of folds. Hello? Okay. Resolution, it will indicate the number of digits which are fully displaying. That is the resolution here. So that we are calculating resolution with the formula 1 divided by 10 to the power n. For example, if the resolution of DVM with n equal to 3 active digits, here active digits means full digits. Mean, so we can take n equal to 3 here. So what we can get? 1 by 10 to the power 3. And if you multiply this whole thing by 100, you are converting that one to 0.1%. So this is how normally we are expressing resolution in terms of percentage. Hello? Okay. So there is some quite hello. Okay. Some quite disturbance or delay may be there because of the net issues. Let us see the sensitivity, that is S equal to lowest full scale of meter into the resolution. Lowest full scale of meter means it will indicate the lowest reading or measurement that meter can do. That is a least count, we can say, in another sense. Okay. So the problem, if we take here, so this problem I hope we already discussed. We'll take another different problem here. A 4.5 digit voltmeter. So what is the meaning of 4.5 digit voltmeter? Means it is able to display full 4 digits and 1.5 digit. That is the meaning. So find its resolution. So first bit, in order to find out the resolution, we have to find out number of full digits which are to be displayed. So 4 are there. So 4, n will become 4 here. So 1 by 10 to the power 4. So resolution, you are getting it as 0.0001. And if you multiply this by 100, so we'll get it in terms of percentage, that is 0.001%. So next, second bit, he is asking how 12.98 volt be displayed on a 10 volt range. Means how many digits are there here? You can see the total number of digits which are displayed are going to be 4. And if you include the decimal digit, it is going to be number of segregated digits more than 4. So 12.98 displayed on 4.5 digits could be like this. So resolution over 1 volt range is going to be, you simply multiply the least resolution, whatever you got, 1.0001 into 1. So that will give the resolution, means the lowest reading that what we can measure with the help of this DVM on 1 volt range. So if you want to measure any voltage less than this much, 0.0001 volt, it is not possible, because it is the minimum voltage that is the resolution indicated by the digital voltmeter on 1 volt range. So that's why you can see, so 12.98, now you can see how many digits are there after decimal point. 1, 2, 3, 4. Means 3 zeros and 1. So totally 4 digits are there. So we are able to display 12.98 as 12.980, another zero if you want, you can put. Similarly, 0.6973 on 1 volt range. The meaning of displaying on 1 volt range means we are expecting these many number of digits after decimal point. 4 digits we are expecting after decimal point. So that's why you can see 0.6973 can be displayed on 1 volt range as 0.6973 because 4 digits are there, 4 digits fully are displayed. Similarly, if you take up both the numerical values to be displayed on both that 1 volt range is over, now we'll take the 10 volt range. Now you can multiply now 10 volt with the least count or the resolution. So what you'll get 0.001. Means your DVM is now able to measure only up to 0.001 voltage, not less than this. Means 3 decimal digits are allowed. So means your 12.98 can be displayed up to 12.980 and 0.6973 now can be displayed as 0.697. 3 will not be displayed, 4 digits, because its least count resolution is only up to the 3rd decimal digits. 4th decimal digit, its capacity is lost on 10 volt range compared to 1 volt range. Are you getting this one? Can anyone tell me?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is how the kind of problems you are getting on resolution and sensitivity. Now, next, let us see what kind of digital multimeters are available in the laboratory or commercially. So all digital multimeters have A to D converters. Just now we have discussed, no? In the previous 2 online sessions, we have in detail discussed about the design of SA type ADC with visible readout display. With at the converter output. So the digital multimeters can be classified as panel meters, which are just placed at one location. Panel meters, which are called panel, they are just placed at one particular location for some specific purpose. For example, in the laboratory or maybe in other locations where particular application is serving. Bench meters, mainly used for standalone operations in hand and visual operating readings, which are going to read both AC and DC voltages, currents and resistances with multiple ranges, which are called bench meters. Next, we got the system meters, which provides electrical BCD output, having display with better control abilities and microprocessor based computing power. Means it has the ability to store the output also. Now these are the 3 types of digital multimeters. We got panel, bench and system meters. Sometimes it may be asked. Now next we can see the important thing is the operation of basic digital multimeter. So it is called digital because everything should be got converted to digital and read out and displayed. And multimeter, multi and meter, means it is capable of measuring more than one physical quantity. Now if you look at this block diagram here, you have to draw this block diagram, you have to practice this. You can see how many different kind of measurements this digital multimeter is doing here. You are applying here, this is here, you can see we got 2 switches here, 2 main switches. In this whole block diagram, one you can see as it is visible, my cursor is moving there. S1A switch will be there, and another one is here, S1B switch. Both the switches are synchronized and working in hand in hand together. Now let us see what are the different things it is going to measure. The first you can see S1A switch is got connected to DCV, it is written. It is able to measure DC voltage,
Another option is available if the S1 is which is ACV, that it is capable of measuring AC voltage. Third option which is available for S1 is which is DCMA, that is a digital, sorry, DC currents in terms of milliampere. And the fourth option available is ohms. It is able to measure ohms also, resistance also. So switch S1 and switch will help you to switch between any one of these four options with another terminal grounded. And this N1 switch is doing the switching operation in synchronization with S1B. Now let us see how the things are going to happen here one by one. So this is the enlarged diagram here for you to easily understand. Now, one thing you will ensure that whatever may be the our measurement, our device, that is digital multimeter. So that's what is known as a multimeter. It is capable of measuring DC voltage, AC voltage, DC current, and resistance. That's what is known. It is capable of measuring multiple physical quantities here. We took here only four examples. Like that, there may be more than four. So when S1 is which is connected to the DCB option, means what we are telling to the meter is that we want to measure DC voltage, not AC. So now whatever the input you are giving for which we want to measure DC voltage, it should be connected or given as input to the attenuator. Attenuator's main duty, as already explained, if your input amplitude is very large, that we cannot be able to make out it or to see on the display of the CRO or on the screen, then we have to zoom in, zoom it, something like zoom in and zoom out. Proportionally, we want to reduce it, its amplitude. So that is actually done by the attenuator block here. Then here, after attenuator, we'll be getting another switch is going to play its role. This S1B switch is acting in synchronization with S1A and connecting DCV. You can see here S1B connected to DCV. And here we got another switch here. Now it is visible, S1C. DCV is now connected. And both sides S1B, S1C are got synchronized with S1A switching. Now the permission is given by all the three switches to the DC voltage to measure the DC voltage. Now you can see what will happen. So when input is applied at S1A switch, DCV is connected as input to the attenuator, then its output will be synchronously connected to S1B, S1C switches, asking them to let this is output of attenuator will be given or connected as input to A to D converter. A to D converter is a must because it is a digital voltmeter we are dealing. Everything we need to convert it to digital. Now here you can see, it will be got converted equivalent to the digital, counted by this decoder counter and display. So this last output section, what you are observing here, A to D converter, that is ADC, counter and display. So this section will be remaining common for all the four types of physical quantities to be measured. Whatever you want, you can bring here the physical quantity to be measured with the help of three switches. It will be finally converted to digital, counted, then count will be displayed. Equivalent count, suppose if you are measuring 5 volts DC voltage, then its equivalent count we are getting on the display, only 5. It is not mentioning any unit there. Volt, millivolt, microvolt, DC volt, AC volt, it is not going to display anything there. Is not going to give the description of what measurement you are doing. It's simply giving you the equivalent count. That's why you can see after ADC, you are simply counting and counted pulse will be displayed and those counted pulses are equivalent to the what DC voltage you want to measure. That's all. Understanding this one? Okay. So next, suppose if you want to measure AC voltage, now suppose S1A switch is connected . Now we can see next, when S1A switch is connected to ACB here, you can see. Now you are telling to the instrument, digital voltmeter, that I want to measure AC voltage. Then it will be given as input to the compensated attenuator. Compensated means attenuator here, along with attenuation, it is going to compensate for some value of the AC input voltage. So that voltage will not be lost. That is the difference between attenuator and compensated attenuator. Compensation, you can see, no? Little meaning of compensation, compensation money or something like that. In the similar way, here compensated attenuator, it is going to compensate for some magnitude or input or some parameter of the AC input voltage that maybe we are not going to see there. That will be compensated here. Proportionality is made visible. Then it will be passed through rectifier. So why we need rectifier here? Because AC is there. We want it to convert it to pulsating DC. Here you can see, we are getting here in switch S1C, we are getting pulsating AC, not AC, because rectifier is involved here. Now S1C, which is synchronously connected to ACV with respect to the S1A, and allowing this pulsating DC, now given as input to A to D converter, again converted to DC, digital, counted by decade counter, and its equivalent count, the number of pulses will be once again counted and displayed. That's all. Last three sections, their job will be remaining same. So this is how the rectifier we want, because we want to measure AC, but we are, our device is a digital voltmeter. So how digital voltmeter can measure AC voltage? Obviously, we need to convert it to DC only. Means pulsating DC. Rectifier will not give us the ideal DC here. So pulsating DC, that is actually the AC itself we are actually measuring here, converted here. And converted to digital with help of ADC, counted by decade counter, and that count of pulses, equivalent count in the AC input voltage, just for example, like 3 volt peak to peak, only equivalent pulses will be counted and displayed. That's all. It's not going to give any more description, it's just going to give the number counted by the counter. That is equivalent to your AC voltage. That's all. Similarly, next you can see how to measure. Now suppose the S1A switch is connected to the third option, that is a DC milliampere. Means by connecting S1A to DC milliampere option, we are instructing the DVM that we now want to measure DC current in terms of milliamperes. So for this we can see, we want to convert, because we are measuring input current here. So far, any measurement you know, DC voltage, AC voltage, input add voltage. Simply, we made some conversions and got ADC counted and displayed response. This input current, we want to convert it to voltage. So here, current to voltage converter is there. Actual current to voltage, this is the new circuit. So in order to explain this, so here, current to voltage, how we are going to convert current to voltage? So unknown current is coming here. This is the op-amp. Input we are applying to the inverting terminal, inverting op-amp. And here many
variable feedback resistors are there, 1 kilo ohm, 100 ohm, 10 ohm, like that. So whenever the unknown current is coming here at the inverting terminal, suppose if you are connecting to 10 ohm, means this amount of current is going to provide some drop across 10 ohm, or it is going to provide some drop across 100 ohm or 1 kilo ohm, whatever your design will be there. I have shown you some examples here. Based on the design of this inverting op amp, so whatever the design parameter we got, we are going to connect that one. And it is having some voltage drop across that. Resistor is having some voltage drop. Means what is happening here is that unknown current, what you are going to measure, supposed to measure, it is now converted to its equivalent voltage drop across these resistors. Now that voltage is applied as input to AD converter, not current directly. So that's what it is happening here. This is how the current is converted to voltage with the help of that inverting op amp. Means when you switch S1A to DC milliampere, this current in terms of milliampere will be first converted to equivalent voltage with the help of that current to voltage converter circuitry, that is an inverting op amp. Now you can see its output is coming here, one of the option in S1C switch. Here you can see. Okay. So here S1C is got synchronously connected with this output of current to voltage converter and given as input to ADC to convert it to digital. Then its output will be given to counter to count the pulses. Then counted pulses will be displayed. That is equivalent to the DC milliampere. Only counting number will be displayed. It is not showing any milliampere, millivolt, AC volt, DC volt, DC milliampere. No, it is simply just indicating some number, and that number is just nothing but refers to the counting of this counter. That is equivalent to the DC milliampere what we supposed to measure. This is how the current will be measured. Now let us see the last one also, so we'll get an idea. Basically, this whole meter is going to operate. Now, in order to measure, suppose if S1 is connected to ohms, last option. Hello. Yes. Now, when S1A is connected to ohms, the fourth option. Now we are instructing DVM, that is digital multimeter. We want to measure resistance. Means these are the two terminals you are now observing, no? So whether you know or not, maybe you may be knowing, you maybe did in PUC also, or maybe in the first year. So how you are going to measure the resistance? Any resistance has got two metallic ends, and suppose if you want to measure its resistance, you need to connect plus to one terminal and minus to another metallic terminal of the resistance. Okay, the moment when you connect both the terminals of resistance to the meter, then we can see here. Constant current source is there. The moment when resistance got connected to the multimeter, this current source starts sending current through that resistance. Means this is constantly sending the current. It's simply waiting for some resistance to be connected, both terminals to be connected. The moment when both terminals are connected, the current from this constant current source will start flowing through that resistance. Voltage drop will happen. And that voltage drop is coming here in S1C switch, connected or given as input to AD converter to be converted to digital. That will be counted by counter and will be displayed. Means we are not actually measuring ohms here. We are actually measuring voltage only, voltage across the resistance. So when you are going to measure DC milliampere, we are not actually measuring current here, but we are converting current to voltage, and that voltage we are measuring. Similarly, when you are going to measure AC voltage, we are not real sense, of course, maybe doing the measurement of AC voltage, but we are converting once again to DC voltage, pulsating voltage, that will be measured.
Similar in DC voltage, you are missing voltage only. In all these cases, so what is the common thing? The end thing, at the end of the day, we are measuring voltage only. That will be converted to digital, counted by decade counter and display. That's all. It's over. So the only key point in the whole operation of digital multimeter is simply whatever the physical parameter you want digital multimeter to measure, simply convert it to voltage form, voltage energy form, give it to ADC, decade counter and display. That's all. So this is how you need to explain about digital multimeter. Okay. So I want to take a pause here. So I want to ask whether the things are clear. Anybody can respond? Because it is important. Anyone can respond? Okay, everybody is sleeping. So next we'll go for digital frequency meter. So very good professionalism you are showing here. So we cannot change the things. So hard. So next you can see digital frequency meter. That is the principle of operation. So this is the basic principle of operation here. Lies in the actual definition of frequency itself. If you look at this figure here, so this itself is indicating operating principle of DFM, that is a digital frequency meter. On one input, you have 1 second width of square wave pulse, and another input, we got a train of very small width pulses are there. Okay, so this is the AND gate. For 1 second, this AND gate is on. As long as this 1 second pulse for which this square wave pulse is on, these all small pulses will be passed through this AND gate, which are counted. That is a frequency. What is the frequency? Number of pulses per second, isn't it? Are you getting this one? Number of pulses here, what which are crossing through this AND gate in 1 second. That is a frequency measurement, isn't it? That is a basic principle of operation. But due to high speed electronic counters, high speed signal can be measured. Now let us see the basic circuit for the digital frequency meter. So actually, this is a very rough diagram. Actual diagram, we can see it later here. So all of you listen this one, it is very easy to understand. Later you can see the video also. So this is the basic circuitry for the measurement of frequency here. Part of circuitry I am showing here. Hello? Hello? Yeah. So here, for explanation purpose, I am showing just a part of the whole circuitry. Your whole circuitry is here. Later you can see. Whole circuitry will come in the coming slides. Now the main heart of this DFM. Hello? Okay, the voice is coming with some delay. Okay. So the main basic component for the operation of frequency measurement is this one, gate control flip-flop. This gate control flip-flop consists of two back-to-back connected SR flip-flops. Okay, two back-to-back connected SR flip-flops. Two AND gates, and this is the main circuitry, main highway of this frequency measurement. So unknown frequency, what you want to measure will be given as input here in the unknown frequency block. That unknown frequency for which you want to measure its frequency should be converted into
that unknown frequency signal for which we want to measure the frequency should be converted to a train of square pulses with the help of Schmitt trigger. Because you can see in the operation to the A input in the previous slide, we simply apply pulses, number of pulses to be counted in 1 second. I will do once again. Unknown frequency signal, what we want to measure. Hello? Hello?
Hello? Am I audible there?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Okay, let me continue with this one. Some network issues there.
We are getting some breaking or delayed version. So you can see the figure here. The input for which we want to measure frequency will be given first as input to the Schmitt trigger. The Schmitt trigger first at the A input a train of pulses to be counted in 1 second. That is the frequency. Frequency means what? The number of pulses per second. So those pulses we want to count in 1 second which we are passing. So those pulses we are getting with the help of Schmitt trigger. That's why we are applying the input signal. Hello. So that is why we are applying an input whose frequency is to be measured, which is now later converted to train of square wave pulses with the help of Schmitt trigger and applied as input to A of the main gate.
Now let us see how the whole operation is going to operate here. So all of you listen this one carefully. So when a fresh, if we want to do the measurement of frequency, we after the main gate or the counter and display is there, first we have to reset that counter. First, we have to reset the counter.
So we have to do the stop operation. Getting this one? Hello?
Yeah. So first we have to do the stop operation. So stop operation, we are telling the main gate and counter that please stop whatever the previous frequency measurement is you are doing, you have to stop it. So that we are doing with the help of stop operation. Next, start operation will be there. So here we are going to reset the counter in the start operation. I will repeat once again. The operation. We are resetting the counter.
We are resetting the counter and beginning the frequency measurement from the starting. Then we'll go with the next pulse from the time base. You can see here, pulse from the time base selector is given. Okay, so this is the time base selector is nothing but the range. What range you are going to select? So some ranges will be there. For example, suppose now our duty is to measure the frequency. So whether you want to measure in terms of hertz, kilohertz, megahertz, gigahertz, so that scale will be selected with the help of this time-based selector. Accordingly, the width of this square wave pulse will be decided
as long as the width of the pulse at B is there, so those millisecond wave pulses from the A will be transferred from the main gate to the counter and displayed. That is the main operating principle. That's what we have seen in the last slide. Let us see one by one how the stop operation will happen, where we are going to stop the previous measurement. In start operation, we are going to reset the counter and bringing the fresh measurement and continuing the measurement. So all of you listen here carefully as the voice is breaking, with some animation also I have did here. Now let us see how to do the stop operation. Okay, so the main, I already told, the heart of this DFM is gate control flip-flop, which will consist of two back-to-back connected SR flip-flops along with two AND gates, which are acting like start gate and stop gate. Start gate we are using to initiate the start operation, and stop gate we are using to initiate the stop operation. So let us see, the first part in the operation will be the stop operation. We'll begin the stop operation by resetting the flip-flop 1. Okay. We'll begin the operation by assuming R equal to 0. We'll reset the flip-flop. That is R equal to 0. S will be complementary. That will become 1. Y will follow S. Y bar will be complementary to 2Y. Now we can see Y is 1 connected to A. So with Y equal to 1, flip-flop 1 is set. Okay. How we begin our stop operation? We'll begin our stop operation with R equal to 0 and S equal to 1. That will set our flip-flop 1. With this, hello, okay. With this set flip-flop 1, Y is 1 is there, which is connected to A input of stop gate. Y bar is 0, that is connected to A input of start gate. Now as Y bar is 0, A input is 0, start gate, it is not going to function, start gate is not operating. Now Y is 1, that is connected to A input of stop gate. Now stop gate is enabled because B is a common, that we are getting the pulses always from the time base selector. Time-based selector is nothing but the range at which you kept. Whether you want to measure the frequency in the range of hertz, in the range of kilohertz, megahertz, gigahertz, that one. So that pulse is always connected to both the gates, start and stop gate. That is there. Only we are waiting for whether we are getting the pulse at stop or start gate with the help of A. Now we got one for A at the start. Stop gate output is enabled. Stop gate output will become 1. That you can see, that is connected to S of the flip-flop 2. That is going to set your flip-flop 2. So hence Y will become 1. Y bar will become 0. So when Y bar will become 0, that is connected to B input of the main gate. Main gate is now stopped. Because A is always applying the square wave pulses. When one of the input is 0, this is the AND gate. Output will become 0, then no more square wave pulses from the Schmitt trigger will be given to the counter to be counted. So this is how we are telling or making, stopping the previous measurement if it is happening. Are you getting this one? Can anyone tell me? It is very important. Still we go further.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Okay, next we'll see how to do the start operation. Now we'll begin the start operation. You can see the digit at R got changed from 0 to 1. Okay. Previously we put digit 0 at R. So that S was 1, we got set the flip-flop 1. Now R got 1 with the help of this read pulse. Now start reading the pulses. And at the same time, this pulse will also be applied to the here the counter, to reset the counter, 0, 0, 0, 0. That's why I told in the start operation to reset the counter also and display also. Adu reset 0. Adu reset. Okay, why this is low? How?
Hello. Okay, wait a minute. Okay. So I want to repeat here because of the network we lost that portion. So start operation, we are going to begin with the read pulse. So with the read pulse, I am applying 1 to the R, and same thing also got applied to the counter and display unit to reset them. Because now we are doing a fresh frequency measurement. Now with R equal to 1, AM 0, S will become 0. With S equal to 0, Y will become 0. Y bar will become 1. Now with Y equal to 0, stop gate will not function, but start to picture. Okay, with the Y bar equal to 1, now start gate come into picture. Hello, Y bar equal to 1. Hello, okay. With Y bar equal to 1, start gate will come into picture. Now you can see the digit here. Flip-flop 1 will be reset and stop gate is output will be 0. S will become at the flip-flop 2, S will become 0 and hence S equal to 0 at flip-flop 2 is also going to make it to reset. With the flip-flop 2 reset with S equal to 0, Y will become 0 and Y bar will become 1. Now with Y bar equal to 1, B equal to 1 at the main gate is now active. We'll start letting all start split trigger square wave pulses to enter into the counter, counted and displayed. How long it will continue? Now you can see. So as soon as the start gate is on, 1 is applied to R. R is 1 here. That is going to reset your flip-flop. But 1 at the same time also applied to S. The moment when S will become 1, flip-flop 1 will be set and this is going to make flip-flop 2 reset. So flip-flop 2 set. When flip-flop 2 will become set, then main gate will be disabled. But this will take some time. So start gate 1 aadmele RE1 uirtati, that is going to reset flip-flop 2. Okay. Now you started transmitting these pulses to the counter. How long these pulses will be transferred to the counter? As long as the main gate is on. How long the main gate is on? As long as B is 1. But there is a possibility that B will become 0. Because this start gate pulse 1 is also now applied to S of flip-flop 1. This is going to set your flip-flop 1. That is going to set your flip-flop 2. Flip-flop 2 set aitlo idu main gate B input 0 aagibidutathe. But this will take some time. Till that, some pulses will be transferred. Those will be counted, and those will be counted, and displayed. So this is how the digital frequency meter is going to operate with the stop-start operation and with the next pulse. So what we have discussed so far, so this whole horizontal line we have seen. Input signal amplify if you want to, you can amplify for which signal you want to measure frequency. If it is very small, then you can amplify. Split trigger will convert that unknown signal frequency to the train of pulses to be transferred. This is the decimal counter and with the decimal unit. And here you can see this is the A and this is the B input. Here is your gate flip flop. Gate flip flop, put it on node. This one. So, okay. Whole operation it is shown. The Allah gate provide the list. This is the gate flip-flop.
ಇಲ್ಲಿ ಸ್ಪಿಟ್ ಟ್ರಿಗರ್ಲಿಂತ ಟೈಮ್ ಬೇಸ್ಡ್ ಸಿಗ್ನಲ್ ಬರ್ತದಂದಿಲ್ಲ, ಟೈಮ್ ಬೇಸ್ ಸೆಲೆಕ್ಟರ್ ಇರ್ತೈತಿ ನೋಡ್ರಿ. ನೀವು 1 second ಮೀನ್ಸ್ 1 hertz ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಮೇಜರ್, 100 milliseconds ಮೀನ್ಸ್ 1/100 millisecond ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ ಹರ್ಟ್ಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ವಾಂಟ್ ಟು ಮೇಜರ್ ಯು ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಸ್ವಿಚ್ ಟು ದಿಸ್. If you want, you can measure 1 megahertz, that is 1 microsecond time, you can connect here. So these things are actually generated by 1 megahertz crystal oscillator. So this crystal oscillator is successively divided by 10. That is 10 to the power 6 divided by 10. It 10 to the power 6 direct control 1 microsecond. When you divide 1 megahertz by 10, what you will get? 10 microsecond. When you further divide that by 10, you will get 100 microsecond. Again divided by 10 will get 1 millisecond, like that up to 1 second. This will form the time-based selector that will give the option for the user to select at what range the frequency to be measured, which will be converted to the pulse, and that is a time-based selector input you are getting here. Here you can see. So time-based selector input you are getting here. Are you getting this point? Can anyone tell me here? So this is the main block diagram, and this block diagram, so both the diagrams you have to draw there in the exam. This is the main block diagram, and gate control flip flop is the main heart of this DFM. That what we have explained as a part of the DFM operation. Have you understood this one? Can anybody tell me? If you have any some silly doubts are also there, you can tell me now itself. So I have the things here, you can easily explain. So next, extending high frequency measurement, that you can see in the next session. So can anyone tell me, have you understood this? This is the very two important devices operation we are covering today. That is a digital multimeter and digital frequency meter. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Nope.